PT and TOEFL now can be used for Canada study visa applications under SDS visa category, along with IELTS Academic and IELTS GT scores. Also, IELTS Academic score requirement has changed as well, starting from August 10th, 2023. So there is a lot of confusion among students about their Canada study visa application. In this video, I'm going to share all the updates and how you can plan your Canada study visa application in future and about SDS versus non-SDS visa categories as well. So watch this video till the end. Hello everyone, welcome back to this YouTube channel, The Immigration Gurus. This is Jitendra Grover, and in this video, I am sharing all the new updates about Canada study visa applications under SDS visa category. I am also going to share SDS versus non-SDS and which is more recommended to you and what kind of things can happen in future, maybe in June, maybe in July, maybe in August. So in next 2-3 months, there are going to be updates related to SDS visa categories, and these type of changes are happening in past as well. Now, there are these changes are quite big right now because new categories, new test categories are added under SDS category. So this is a big change in SDS category since the introduction of SDS category in many countries. So let me share my screen and share all the updates one by one. Okay, so SDS is Student Direct Stream. This is the official website of IRCC, and SDS initially, it was introduced in 5 countries. Now it is available in 14 countries. India is one of them. So from India, Pakistan, you can apply under SDS visa category. Now it is in 14 countries. So all the 14 countries can apply under SDS category. Wherever SDS category is there and it is introduced, there the acceptance rate under SDS category is always, always higher compared to non-SDS visa category. So if you are not going to follow the requirements of SDS category, your application will automatically fall under non-SDS, and the refusal rate in non-SDS is usually higher compared to SDS. So it is always, always recommended to apply under SDS visa category. In my scenario, in my cases, with my clients, most of the cases are complex cases, mature cases. For them, it is always highly recommended that you apply under SDS category. I do not recommend or I do not apply. In 99.9% cases, I do not apply under non-SDS. Most of the time, I go with SDS only, and this is recommended for everyone. And that is kind of one of the things behind having the high visa acceptance rate, even in the most complex cases. So we stay confident if we are under SDS category. We know that if we are taking care of the case, then sooner or later, we are going to get visa. Even after 5, 7, 10 refusals, we have got visa. I have cases where people have got visa after 7 refusals and all the cases were through me. I have cases where all the refusals were through someone else, 5, 6, 7 refusals. And in one attempt, I got visa. So I'm not sure when you are going to get visa, but we are sure that if the profile is fine, if we are taking care of it, and if SOP is right, documentation is right, and we are falling under SDS, and you are going to a good university, right program, you will definitely get visa. With the past experience, we have understood that you will definitely get visa. It's not a problem. When you are going to get it, we don't know. But if you are under SDS category, then definitely you will get it. So the requirement wise, till now on this website, the requirement is older requirement. You require 6 in all module, either in IELTS Academic or in IELTS General. So just remember, IELTS GT is also accepted under SDS category, because even on the official website, it is nowhere written that it is you require IELTS Academic. We have already got so many visas with IELTS GT, because most of the mature cases, they initially try for PR, they give IELTS GT. And after having their IELTS GT score, we apply with that IELTS GT score under SDS category, and they get visa as well. IELTS GT in most scenario cannot be used for getting admission. There is an alternate for that. I'm going to share it very soon. So first requirement right now is 6 in all module, either in IELTS Academic or in IELTS GT. The same previous criteria is written on the official website, because the new rules, new amendments are going to be implemented starting from August 10th. So maybe in August, we will see a change in the official website. But right now, it is not there on official website. Second requirement is you need to pay at least $10,000 GIC. That is for your survival and expenses in Canada for next 1 year for the student. So $10,000 GIC is required. And next is first year of tuition fee you need to pay. Then next is you need to have medical, upfront medical you need to do. So these are the basic requirements. Two more things are added, which are quite basic. So you require to have letter of acceptance from a DLI, any college or university which is recognized. So you require to have letter of acceptance from there. Of course, you need to have it. And you need to submit transcripts, latest educational transcript. So just mark this recent secondary or post-secondary educational transcript. So your previous transcripts, previous education is not mandatory to be submitted. So if you are having like 70% marks in MBA and 45% marks in BBA, then do not submit your BBA degree. You can just submit MBA and it is perfectly fine. It is allowed. It is clearly mentioned on the website as well. You can read it. So on the official website under SDS, all the basic requirements are mentioned, but PT and TOEFL, it is not still not included here because these changes are going to be implemented in August. So what you should do in this scenario, I'm going to discuss that as well. Should you wait or what should you do if your score is good in PT, if your score is good in TOEFL, if you are meeting the SDS criteria, what you should do. So we are going to discuss very soon in this video about that as well. So this update is given on IDP website, IELTS IDP website. So you can see that there is one major change related to IELTS requirement under SDS. So initially, right now, it is 6 in all module. Minimum 6 in all module is required. So in writing, reading, listening, speaking, in all the modules, 6 is required. But now it is changed in a new rule, which is going to be starting, which will be starting from August 10th. So you require overall 6. Individual score can be 5.5 in any module, doesn't matter. If you have overall 6, in that case, it will fall under SDS category. So this is one big change in the current scenario. So IELTS Academic, if you have 6 overall, that will work for you under SDS category. So right now, this is one update. So you can keep noting all the updates. One scenario is also given. If you are having 5.5 in reading, and in writing, you have 6 in all module. Overall, it becomes 6. It is perfectly fine. And you can still be eligible to apply under SDS category. So if you are having less score, 5.5 in one module, two modules, three modules, it doesn't matter. If you are having overall 6 in IELTS Academic, then it is perfectly fine. And you can use it under SDS category. I hope it is clear. So there is one table given as well. So if you are having like overall 6, even if your score is 5.5, 5.5 in two modules, 7.5 in listening, 5.5 in speaking. So three module you are having 5.5, but due to listening, your score is 6. You are perfectly fine. And you can use IELTS Academic under SDS category. So this is a big relief for many people because many times it happens that your score is less in writing or in reading and you have to take your test again and again. So that becomes a problem for you and you are unable to apply under SDS. Application goes in non-SDS. And in most of the cases where you apply with 5.5 in any module under non-SDS, almost in all cases you get refusal. So it is not recommended at all. So that's why now this will become a relief. How IRCC is going to react to it? We will get to know about it in future, but for now, if this is implemented in that case, at least you will fall under SDS and it will be a big relief for many people. IELTS GT, this is a bit tricky. IELTS GT is accepted under SDS category, but you need to score 6 in all modules under IELTS GT. So if you want IELTS GT to be used under SDS category, in that case, your score should be 6 in all modules. So you require to take CLB benchmark 7, which is 6 in all module. Then only your application will go in SDS if you are using IELTS GT. So this relief is not there for IELTS GT. It is there for IELTS Academy. So for IELTS GT, you need to follow the previous criteria of 6 in all module and overall 6 as well. And for IELTS Academic, there is a relief that even if you have 5.5 in any module, still it will fall under SDS. So IELTS Academic people, they have got the relief. One more small thing is written here out of context, but you should keep it in mind. So many people ask me, our IELTS is expiring on so and so date, and can we go for January intake? So if your IELTS is expiring in July next month, can you go for January intake? Yes, definitely you can use this test score to go for January intake as well. If you have got your admission done, in that case, whenever we are applying for your visa application, suppose we are applying for your visa application today and your IELTS score is expiring next month, it is perfectly fine. even if you get your result after the expiration of your IELTS test, it doesn't matter. Whenever we are applying or submitting for your visa application, that day your IELTS should be valid. Your IELTS is valid for 2 years. Whenever you get your TRF, till that date, starting from that date to two years, your IELTS is valid. And if you are applying your Canada study visa application with a valid IELTS score, even if the validity is left for 2 days, 5 days, 1 day, it is valid for SDS or any visa category. You can use it for your Canada study visa application. And if you are going for a later intake, it does not matter. While traveling to Canada, you need not to carry your valid IELTS score. It is not a mandatory thing. You need to carry your IELTS score, which you submitted while submitting your Canada study visa application. So if your IELTS expires next month, and if you are traveling in January, does not matter. If you have got your visa, this IELTS is perfectly fine. You can keep it with you and travel to Canada. And here is the big update, big amendment. So IELTS Academy 6 overall is required for under SDS category. PT overall 6 means individual score is not mentioned. Overall 6, overall 60 is there. If it is there, in that case, it will fall under SDS category. And in TOEFL, if overall 83 is there, it will fall under SDS category. CAEL, we don't follow this test popularly in India or in other countries. If it is there, then 60 overall is required to fall under SDS. But other score, 60 is quite nominal in PT. If you have that, in that case, bingo, good to go for SDS. And if you have TOEFL 83, which is quite easy. So with that as well, you can go for SDS category. And IELTS Academic, I have already shared it with you. Same kind of news is mentioned on PT website as well. So the news is already out, but hopefully it is going to be implemented smoothly, and we will get the official update on this website as well, because until unless it is on this website, it is completely unofficial. Why it is completely unofficial? Because there are so many things which are announced or which are there, but there is a disclaimer as well with all those things that this is not an official statement. This is not an official statement. There are always disclaimers there with all the tweets and information which is floating on internet. So hopefully it is implemented the way it is stated on all the websites and stated by IRCC as well. If it is there on this website, then definitely you can believe it, and we can proceed with that application. Okay, how to plan about your Canada study visa now? If you have like 6 in all modules, IELTS Academic, IELTS General, you have got your admission done. Everything is fine. No need to wait. Apply under SDS category, whether you're going for September intake, whether you're going for January intake, get your admission done and go for it. There is no problem in that. So in that scenario, it is quite straightforward. SDS category, you need not to wait for anything. And this update is kind of not for you. You are already good for SDS and there are no changes for you. If you are not falling under SDS right now, so for them, how you should plan for your Canada study visa. So if your application is already going on with PT, so in that case, and if your score is 60, if your score is not 60, in that case, you need to take your PT again. So start taking your test, start preparing for your test. And if you are ready for your test, at least score 60 overall in your PT, so that in future, after 2 months, you can fall under SDS category and you can apply under SDS category. And then your application will be far stronger to get your Canada study visa. There won't be any problem. If your score is 60 right now, should you stop applying for Canada study visa right now because your application is going under SDS, under non-SDS? No. From my side, the recommendation is you can apply for at least 2 or 3 times under non-SDS. If you have got your Canada study visa right now, if you get your Canada study visa this month or next month, in that case, it can save a lot of time for you and you may be able to catch September intake. No need to wait for August to apply for your Canada study visa. Apply right now. At least take 2 or 3 attempts under non-SDS category. If you don't get your visa, then after 2 or 3 attempts, wait now. After that, defer your admission to January intake and then apply under SDS. So if you are having this kind of scenario where your PT score is 60, do not stop your non-SDS application. Apply at least 2 or 3 or 4 times. Even if you are getting refusal, at least you are taking your chances for Canada study visa. If you get visa with non-SDS, still you are good. And you may be able to join September intake and it can save a lot of time. So that is my recommendation. Apply, 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 apply until unless we reach to a condition where we reach to August month, and then we can see that, okay, now we will go for SDS only. Now we are not going to submit under non-SDS. At least take 2 or 3 attempts under non-SDS. So this is one recommendation. Same is for TOEFL as well. If you are falling under non-SDS and trying to get your visa, do not withdraw. And you can just keep reapplying. Even if you are getting refusal, you can get visa after refusals as well. I do not care about refusals much now, because we know that how Canada distribute refusals. If there are 10 lakh applications at a time, everyone is not going to get visa, and people are going to get random refusals under SDS as well. In non-SDS, refusal rate is higher. In SDS, it is less, but random refusals are there under SDS and non-SDS, both the categories. But the quantity is higher. The percentage is higher under non-SDS. So take your chances under non-SDS as well. There is a second type of scenario as well, where you are now applying for admission and trying to get admission in January intake. Right now, you are getting January intake. September is almost closed for everyone. So if you are going for January intake, in that case, you have a lot of time, like 7-8 months of time. In that scenario, no need to hurry for your Canada study visa application right now. So you can wait for a month and directly fall under SDS category after August 10th. So in August as well, after that as well, you have 5 months of time to get your visa. So in that scenario, if you are applying for January intake, if your admission is done, or if you are still trying to get your admission done, in that case, just wait for your application, directly apply under SDS category in August with your PT or TOEFL. So that will be a better scenario for you, because for January, we have a lot of time. So get your admission done and wait for your visa application till August. Third thing is, there is one more concern which is there related to admission. So your IELTS score now means in future, if your IELTS requirement is overall 6, will you get admission with that overall 6 or not? So will admission criteria be changed in Canada or not? Because it has happened in past as well. The requirement under SDS is different, but the admission criteria is different, and you are unable to get admission. Suppose you have 3 module 5.5, 1 module 7.5, will you get admission? It will be eligible for SDS category, eligible for visa as well, but will it be eligible for admission or not? So that kind of criteria can also happen. That kind of problem can also happen in future. So try to get 6 in all modules so that you can secure admission as well. But there is an alternate as well, which is going on. But that alternate is medium of instruction letter. So suppose McEwen University accept medium of instruction letter to give you admission. So that is also possible. Cape Breton University gives you admission with medium of instruction letter. So you can get a letter from your college or university that you studied in English. Your entire study is in English. With that, you can get admission. So some colleges and universities are there, like McEwen University is a good option. CBU is a good option. There you can get admission with medium of instruction letter as well. Or you can get admission with Duolingo score as well. So Duolingo is now almost normalized, and it is still being used even after COVID as well. It came in COVID, but it is still used by the colleges and universities for admission. So you can take Duolingo test as well for your admission. So you can have an alternate test or medium of instruction letter for your admission, and you can use overall 60 or overall 6 in IELTS Academic for your visa application. Also, you can use IELTS GT. Similar kind of thing is there, because IELTS GT in most scenario cannot be used for admission. So you can use IELTS GT for visa application and Duolingo or medium of instruction letter for your admission. So for admission, we can have a different system. For visa application, we can have a different system. We can have common system as well. Suppose you have IELTS Academic 6 in all modules, same can be used for admission, and same can be used for your visa application as well. So common can be there, but different system can be there, where Duolingo or medium of instruction is used for admission, and IELTS overall 6, PT, TOEFL, IELTS GT is used for your visa purpose. Fourth, I have one more doubt, means this entire decision of SDS can be a political kind of decision. We don't know how IRCC is going to react to it, because many times it happens that visa result is on the discretionary power of visa officer, and we have seen many random refusals as well. With this particular update, number of applications under SDS are going to be increased. Overall number of applications are also going to be increased, because many times consultants stop application because 2 module 5.5 are there. Overall it is it is 6, but we still don't submit application. Many times we stop application because of less particular score in PT. So it has happened in past as well. All those students will become eligible for applications now. So number of applications are going to rise. So how IRCC is going to react it will we will get to know about it in future as future only. Right now, no one can comment on it because this update may be completely a political kind of decision, maybe influenced by something, maybe influenced by PT or TOEFL or something. We don't know what kind of things are going behind the curtain, but how IRCC is going to react to the applications, where the score is 5.5 in two modules, three modules, how IRCC is going to react to those applications, whether they are going to allow visa or not. So it will be on their discretionary power. After submitting a few applications only, we will get to know about this. So this is one concern I am having right now, and there won't be any resolution of it currently until unless we submit application and we get the result for those applications. So I hope after this video, you must be able to plan your application better. And there are three quick updates. One is there is application fee waiver right now going on. For the first application, you can submit your application for free with the Immigration Gurus. So submit your application as soon as possible. It is there till 15th of this month, 15th of June. So just submit your application as soon as possible. First application will be free of cost. So you can save like 5,000-6,000 rupees quite easily. And you can connect with your friends who are kind of in the process of submitting applications. If you don't have IELTS, still you can submit your application. IELTS, PT, nothing, if nothing is there, still you can submit application using Duolingo or medium of instruction letter. So if you are waiting for your IELTS test, do not wait. Submit your application, get admission, and then take your IELTS or PT or TOEFL, whatever you want to take. So with that, you can submit application. So you can save money on this. Till 15th, this scheme is there. I don't know whether we are going to extend it or not. So this is one thing. Second, you can become an independent agent with the Immigration Gurus. So you can ping me for the details on my number 98123-80882. And if someone is interested in taking a franchise in your city, in that case, you can connect me for that as well. I hope video is informative. If so, like, subscribe, and share the video as much as possible. See you in next video.